Yo, what's going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be counting down the top 7 best duos in 5 years. And this isn't guys that play on the same line. It could be two players from a team that are basically the best players on that team. And I'm going to be ranking what teams have the best, you know, two players in 5 years. So that's what this is going to be. They don't have to be on the same line. They could be a defense and a forward, etc. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy and let me know your thoughts down in the comment section. Coming in at number 7 is a defensive pairing coming out of Columbus, and that's Zach Werenski and Seth Jones. Zach Werenski probably learned a lot from Seth Jones in his rookie season, as he had a crazy rookie year that really came out of nowhere. Seth Jones played in 75 games last year, had 12 goals, 30 assists for 42 points, and Zach Werenski played in 78 games and had 11 goals, 36 assists for 47 points, so they combined for 87 points as a defense pairing. So that is very, very good, and these guys are the defense for the future for Columbus, and they have to lock them up long term because these guys are going to be dynamite on the blue line. At number 6 is a forward defense combo coming out of Boston, and that's David Pastrnak and Charlie McAvoy. Charlie McAvoy barely even played this year, but in the games he played, he looked like an elite defenseman, and he's only 19 years old, so that's what's most impressive in my opinion. And David Pastrnak is really the forward of the future for the Boston Bruins, and he's only 21 years old. Pastrnak played 75 games last year and had 34 goals and 36 assists for 66 total points, which is a very, very good total. And Charlie McAvoy holding it down in the defensive area is going to be great. These two as a combo is going to be great in the future for the Boston Bruins. So Boston Bruins fans should have a lot to look forward to with these two young stars. Coming in at number 5 is Sebastian Aho and Jeff Skinner. I really like what Carolina is doing with their young guys. I could have went with a different duo coming out of Carolina. I could have went with Noah Hanifin and Slavin, or one of them great defensemen that they have, but I decided to go with Skinner and Aho, as I think they're going to be a deadly combo for years to come. Jeff Skinner is 25 years old, so in 5 years he will be 30, but I think he'll still be good then. Sebastian Aho is only 20 years old, so let's look at their stats last year. Aho had 82 games played, 24 goals, and 25 assists for 49 total points. Jeff Skinner had 79 games played, 37 goals, 26 assists for 63 total points, so they combined for 112 points, which is a very, very good total, and Jeff Skinner did miss 3 games. So I think Carolina has a very, very bright future and a lot to look forward to. This one could be kind of controversial, but I'm going with Jack Eichel and Alex Nylander. I could have went with Sam Reinhardt or Zemgus Girgensons or one of them type of players, but I decided to go with Alex Nylander because I think William Nylander and Alex Nylander are just going to be pure scorers in the future in the NHL. And he's only 19 years old, so this isn't that long of a shot. He doesn't have much NHL experience with just 4 games played last year. He did have 1 assist in those 4 games. And I think if Jack Eichel can stay healthy, and I do think Nylander will crack the roster next year, I think these guys could be a deadly combo that teams are going to have to look out for, as Jack Eichel's potential in my opinion is just through the roof, as he played in 61 games last year and had 24 goals, 33 assists for 57 points, so almost a point a game. So that's very good, and I think these guys are going to be deadly in the future. Next up is Patrick Laine and Nikolaj Ehlers. These guys are going to just be absolutely filthy in the future, and Winnipeg Jets fans should be very, very excited. Patrick Laine is only 19 years old, and he almost scored 40 goals last year. He played 73 games and had 36 goals, 28 assists for 64 points. And Ehlers, who's 21 years old, had 82 games played, 25 goals, 39 assists for 62 points. So they combined for 126 points, which is a very, 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 very good total. And I think these guys can just make that total rise and rise year after year, and they're going to be a deadly, deadly offensive combo in the near future. Next up at number 2 is Austin Matthews and William Nylander, or you could really choose Mitch Marner, one of the two. It doesn't really matter, but I'm going with Nylander because they're on the same line, but that could change in the future. Austin Matthews and William Nylander. 19 years old Austin Matthews, 21 year old William Nylander. Matthews played 82 games last year and had 40 goals and 29 assists for 69 points, and Nylander played in 81 games and had 22 goals and 39 assists for 61 points, so they combined for 130 points as rookies, which is very, very good. And these guys are just going to be doing great things for the Toronto Maple Leafs, as the Toronto Maple Leafs have a crazy core in place for the next years to come, so Leafs fans should just be ecstatic. And finally at number 1, this shouldn't be a surprise to anybody, Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl. These guys just signed huge, huge contracts, so the Oilers have them locked up for the foreseeable future for very, very long term. And these guys, in my opinion, are going to be the next Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin duo. McDavid's 20 and Dreisaitl's only 21, and they both played in 82 games last year, which shows they can both stay healthy and play all games. McDavid, 30 goals, 70 assists for 100 points. Dreisaitl, 29 goals and 48 assists for 77 points for a combined total of 177 points. For these two guys, they're going to be the top two centers of the Oilers for the next, I don't know how many years. And I think in the next 5 years, these guys are going to be one of the most insane combos the NHL has ever seen. And they're just really turning around the Edmonton Oilers franchise. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about my choice at number one down in the comments. So that just about wraps up this video. I hope you guys did enjoy. Obviously, you're not going to agree with me, so let me know your guys' list down in the comment section below and who you guys think will be dominating the NHL in the next 5 years. And these are just my opinion. It's obviously pure speculation. Obviously, these guys could fall off, but I don't think they will. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video and you want to see more hockey videos like this, make sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications so you know when I upload. And thanks for all the support lately, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video.